When it comes to robotic MIG welding, there has always been debate about whether you should be using air-cooled or water-cooled torches. For most cases, there are obvious reasons why you would choose one over the other, such as amperage rating and duty cycle, material type and thickness, and so on. But sometimes it isn't so cut and dry. It's that gray area that we'll be discussing in this video. There are benefits and downsides to both air-cooled and water-cooled torches. With water-cooled torches, there is more equipment to buy. You need the torch, a water cooler, the coolant, and all the necessary hoses and fittings. But with a water-cooled torch, you can weld at higher amperages for longer periods of time with less wear and tear on your consumables. If your application requires these higher demands, then a water-cooled torch is a no-brainer. If you don't require those higher demands, then pay attention to other factors like overheating and the access your robot has to parts. Consider the material you are using. Is it reflective like aluminum? Are the parts preheated before welding? These factors can increase the working temperature of the torch, and if air-cooled, it could overheat or fail entirely. Access to parts is another reason you may want to consider a water-cooled torch. Why? Because water-cooled torches typically use smaller front-end consumables than air-cooled torches for the same weld capacity. Using air-cooled torches, as I mentioned before, include weld capacity limits and limit access to parts due to larger front-end consumables. But with an air-cooled torch, you don't have to buy nearly as much equipment to accommodate, and in the event of a crash or failure, there's less to fix or replace. With air-cooled torches, you have to be aware of every aspect of your application and make sure that it will meet your demands. If you put an air-cooled torch into an application it can't handle, you risk torch failure and a major hit to the productivity of your process. Air-cooled torches are generally lower cost and are a good option for lower amperage welding. Water-cooled torches running at 100% duty cycle can return to a cooled state in as little as 30 seconds or as long as 2 minutes depending on the amperage load. They can do this because the coolant is running all the way from the water cooler through the power cable and into the front-end consumables. This can't be said for an air-cooled torch that, if run at its load limit, has the potential to get hotter and hotter after each weld, unless it has a torch change to cool down in between. This constant increase in heat can affect the quality of your welds over a period of time, as well as lead to premature wear of the torch's front-end consumables, mainly the contact tips. Something that will surely affect the decision you make is the investment of an air-cooled system versus a water-cooled system. With water-cooled systems, there will be more upfront cost. There's also a little more maintenance involved. You'll need to monitor the system for leaks and change out O-rings in the coolant when necessary. However, due to the extended lifespan of consumables from internal cooling, running the cell itself will be much cheaper over time. Since you are running water-cooled, you can increase your duty cycle and improve productivity of the welding cell overall. It's important to also consider the cost of the downtime associated with consumable changes and failed torches. This isn't something that is easy to see, but can make a huge difference down the road. Air-cooled torches are more simple, robust, and require less maintenance. They are obviously less expensive to get up and running, but you will see a reduction in consumable life when compared to water-cooled. In the instance of a robot crash, an air-cooled torch will typically hold up better because they are built with more solid material for current transfer and have no internal, hollowed-out coolant lines like water-cooled torches do. However, alignment jigs exist for air and water-cooled torches alike, so it's likely any torch that doesn't experience a big crash can be repaired and realigned to a working condition. When you are assessing which is best for your application, it's important to consider the following questions. What is your maximum amperage limit? Remember that the closer to the limit that you are with your torch, the more consumables you will use and possibly jeopardize weld quality. We recommend anything over 400 amps to go with a water-cooled solution. What metal thickness are you welding? More shiny metals like aluminum and thicker materials such as 1/4-inch plate lend themselves to a water-cooled application. What is the duty cycle of your application? If you're running a duty cycle of 50% or lower, an air-cooled torch will probably be sufficient. But anything higher than 60%, we recommend switching to water-cooled. What gas mixture are you using? A straight CO2 gas will be able to achieve the full amperage load of the torch design, but the more you mix the gas with argon, helium, or oxygen, the more amperage capacity you lose. For example, a 75-25 mix of CO2 and argon will likely mean a torch with an amperage rating of 500 would be reduced to a 400 amp rating. This can be reduced even further if more argon is mixed in. Are you pulsing? Similar to gas mixture, pulsing has an adverse effect on welding torch capacity. With pulsed arc welding, the rating of the torch can be reduced up to 35%. There's a lot to consider when deciding on an air-cooled or water-cooled robotic torch. If you contact your local Abacor Benzel sales rep, they can help you decide which would work best for your application.
Hey, thanks for watching. Check out some of our other videos, like this one. Don't forget to share your thoughts on this video in the comments below, and subscribe if you want to be the first to see the latest from Abacore Binzel.